man Dennis Ellis. This is Turn Up the Heat. It's going down, Mr. California Lawyer of the Year. I gotta show him how to cook, though. What you got for me, Big D?
We're gonna start off with a little cream cheese and crab dip.
Using
fresh Maryland blue crab. I'm gonna then take you to a little shrimp Creole, made my way.
Creole!
Extra hot.
Because
we are turning up the heat.
Yes, sir.
Then we're gonna end it off with Bananas Foster.
Guess what?
Ain't no bananas in this, though.
D. Ellis, G. Garvin, turning up the heat.
Let go.
There it is.
It's your boy, D. Garvin. Oh, man. It's you. Turn up the heat style. Hey, it's Matt G. Garvin hanging out with my good friend, Mr. Dennis Ellis, incredible attorney. He think he can cook a little bit, but we're going to talk about it today. Good friend of mine. Thanks for coming by, man. Great to see you.
Thanks, G. Appreciate you having me.
You are an attorney. Tell me about that, because you wanted to play football, right?
You would have to bring up the saddest moment of my life to start the show, right? People always ask me what brought me into the law, and I always say it's because I couldn't pass block that well. And so I wound up getting cut and crying for months and months and months, and then I finally got out of bed and decided I would go back to school and finish, actually. My mom's a lawyer, and it seemed like a natural thing for me to do. I went to Howard University School of Law, and then ultimately became a partner at a major law firm in Los Angeles, the first African-American partner in the history of my firm to start his career there and come up through the ranks. So it was a very, very proud moment.
Congratulations. Was there anything you could use from football and getting through law school?
It's funny you mention that, G, because it's the discipline. That dedication gave me what I need to do well in law school.
Now, do you accept the destiny which you were given and you embrace it?
Well, my grandma would say, God don't make no mistakes. And I'm definitely a better lawyer than I ever was a football player. I've rarely lost as a lawyer, but I lost a lot as a football player.
You often challenge me, you know, about cooking. So what's your inspiration? I mean, do you just love it?
I was raised by women like you. You had sisters, you had a mom.
We have a lot.
We have a lot in common. Right? I was raised by my grandmother and my mother. And so they had me in the kitchen as a young boy.
I remember making rice pudding and peeling onions like having to stand on a milk crate.
There's a picture of my grandmother has of me sitting in a pot.
No.
Now you can imagine how young I must have been to be able to fit sitting in a pot.
Wow.
One of my big inspirations for cooking is probably Luther Vandross.
Really? Why?
Because he's a big man. He can sing. I can't sing a lick.
Right.
So I figure if I'm going to get any girl over to my house, I better be able to get on this stove and do something, right?
You can offer free legal advice, too. You know what I mean?
Some of the girls I date do need some free legal advice from time to time. But we're going to talk about that today. If I can't woo-woo, you know, then I better do something here in this kitchen. What I'm hoping to show you today is how you can make a very, very special meal, something that everybody's going to like, but you can do it in 30 minutes.
Okay. My latest book is Dining In. There's a chapter called Friends and Family. You introduced a couple of recipes. One was the peach cobbler. Tell me why you decided that one for my book.
Because that's a lifelong family recipe.
Cool.
And when I gave my grandmother that signed book for Christmas, I mean, she literally cried.
Thank you.
But my theory of peach cobbler is this. If it tastes good with 3 sticks of butter, it would taste better with 4. The key to peach cobbler is the 2 types of crust. The crispy crust on top and the doughy crust on the bottom. And that's the most critical part of peach cobbler, at least in my mind.
Well, okay. And then the peaches, we're going to get back to that.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, we got a dish right now. Walk me through what we got and let's knock this out. I'm going to grab a plate.
Now, this is a cream cheese crab dip that comes from my mother. The recipe she uses every year during Christmas time. This is a very simple dip.
Okay.
You can make it very quickly and it'll be good. Can you lay the cream cheese on that plate?
Yes. Okay, so we'll lay it out like that.
And I'm gonna give you this spoon.
Okay.
You're gonna ladle a little bit of the cocktail sauce on the cheese right up top.
Just like this?
Yes.
Okay.
And that's just so it's gonna hold the crab.
Okay, so no crab.
Put the Maryland. Blue crab on top.
Okay, now we're gonna make this small and delicate. So it's nice and pretty.
And you're going to ladle now some more cocktail sauce on top of that.
Okay, just a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's looking nice like that. Okay, now we're gonna hit it with a little lemon juice.
Okay.
And I'm gonna get this ready for you.
All right.
So you're gonna type the lemon like this, and you just cut a little bit of the skin off, so it helps when you use your juicer here. It just comes out a little bit more.
Okay.
Now why don't you go ahead and just juice this for me a little bit, Jerry, and put that on top.
Right over the top?
Yep.
How about like that?
That's beautiful. Go ahead and do your thing with the white pepper.
The white pepper.
You taught me the importance of garnishing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Get these right for you. Gotta keep it pretty.
So even when you have people coming over, they're happy. And when you get to church, they don't talk about you.
There you go.
Okay, so we got some nice little half moons. So how about we do it like that? And then we'll just do one more. Like that. How about some of that scallion right there?
There you go.
I think she might be okay with us.
No. This still keeps the integrity of the dish. I like this.
And then how about some of that little green oil right there that we like to keep over here, turn up the heat.
Man, she ain't never seen it look this good before.
Do a little something like that, D. Just because we love it, the balsamic.
Do your thing with it.
Okay, so now what we've done is we've taken Mom's recipe and we added a little bit of that flavor. And then how about we... kick it off with
little
the
crackers.
Okay.
On the side.
We'll let you do the honors.
How about that?
Yeah, so when they come, we'll let them know.
And you just serve it?
Off to the side. Like
cheese,
that right
man.
There. And let them know this is Mom's
Marlin Blue Crab Cream Cheese Appetizer Dip.